It is October 31st and I have got some things to say. Und there we go.
Ja, okay. Now for my morning schnitzel.
Hello, Lucia. What are you doing?
Oh, hey, Zwingli. I'm just starting that thing where I try to reform the Catholic Church since it has turned away from numerous biblical teachings.
Oh, so like you're starting the Reformation?
Yeah, a Reformation, exactly.
Cool. Can I join?
Do you reject the works righteousness of the Pope and confess the chief doctrine of the Christian faith? That man is justified by grace alone, through faith alone?
Yeah, totally.
Okay, cool.
I also reject that the Lord's Supper is actually the body and the blood of Jesus because the papists believe that.
Okay, Zwingli. But the Bible very clearly teaches that Christ is physically present in the sacrament. And the point of a reformation is to be faithful to God's word, not to just be as un-Catholic as possible.
But that's the point of my reformation.
Your reformation?
Bonjour, mes amis. What is, how you say, up?
Oh, hello, John Calvin. Lucy here wants to join my reformation, but he still wants to be a little halfway papist sissy baby.
Nein, this is not true. I just don't want to abandon the sacraments because of your scripture-twisting pope rage.
Abandon the sacraments? Sacre bleu, who would do such a thing?
Zwingli, he says that this is my body means this represents my body.
Oh, Zwingli, what a fool you are.
So you agree with me that the bread and wine are the body and blood of Christ?
Of course. And not the finite is not capable of the infinite.
So you agree with Zwingli then?
No. He says that ease does not mean ease. What lunacy? I say that ease means ease as long as the definition of ease is not ease. Is a completely different position. You're going to need to understand these distinctions, Lucia, my friend, if you want to be a part of my reformation.
This is my reformation.
Reformation, you say? I'd love to get on board.
You would? Even after you've called me a heretic for posting my thesis here? Has your allegiance to the Pope changed because you've seen the errors of his theology?
Not really. It's mostly changed because he won't annul my marriage to that half-barren, pig-faced Spanish bride of mine.
That's not a good reason for leaving the Church of Rome.
Now, Dr. Luther, your short-sighted attitude is precisely the reason why the Church of England has chosen Mr. Calvin here to be the chief theological advisor for our ecclesiastical Brexit. God is sovereign indeed. Soon all the world will confess that Jesus did not die for all the world. Well, not all of us are going to believe that particular doctrine, Mr. Calvin.
Shut up, you filthy renegade.
No, you shut up. This is my reformation now.
Stop trying to steal my reformation.
Now, don't get upset, Dr. Luther. I think I speak for all of us when I say that we're all deeply in your debt. After all, today is the day when you set us free from the shackles of Rome so we could follow your example. By quitting our church bodies and starting a new one the second we don't like the cut of someone's theological jib.
That's not what I did. I got the kicked out.
Ah, same difference. What do you say, Jen? Shall we honor Dr. Luther with a rousing rendition of the Protestant song?
Oui.
Absolutely.
We're on the same team as Luther.
No, you're not.
We are the Protestants. All our traditions are equally valid.
This is not true.
Who cares what we teach about the sacraments
or about the atonement?
God cares about these things.
The most important thing is the common song we sing.
We all hate the Pope. Oh, we are the Protestants. If you believe in the real presence, we'll call you cannibals, but then get mad when you won't commune us.
Thank you for singing that song, Mr. Schlusser.
I sang nothing!
Salute. He making me so mad.
Dude, Leo X, I know, right? I mean, it's like, who does he think he is to change the church's doctrine?
Oh, good. So you future popes, you not change my teachings.
Oh, I think you'd be pretty impressed with us, Mio Fratello. After all, what would you say to a pope who, just like you, hates on the Latin Mass and who's on his way to giving communion to divorced Catholics and who's embraced the 160 million Catholic charismatics you probably would have called Montanist heretics, and who also agrees with you that we totally shouldn't execute heretics anymore because we all started believing in religious freedom in the 1960s, which was also when we decided that people who don't believe in Jesus at all can totally go to heaven. And remember how you wanted to start a crusade against the invading Muslims? Well, guess what? Just like you, this pope also believes that Muslims totally worship the same God as us, and that theirs is a religion of peace. So what would you say to that pope?
I say I'm gonna cut off his head. Why you ask?
Oh. No reason.